You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
Welcome to this class, which will be primarily focused on hair roto. In this class, I will first explain and demo hair roto methodology by incorporating many types of tracking during the process, including how to edit a layer's mocha tracking data. Then I will introduce the roto overlay feature, show how to capture proper motion blur, demo shape opacity, opacity in the timeline curve editor, incremental nudging, and last but not least, the new motion blur controller node and expressions. So my shot is cached through and I need to determine my approach. I need to roto all of her, including her hair. And there's a bit of camera movement and the subject is moving around as well. She moves in X and Y, rotating, and also a bit in Z space or depth. I'm going to try to utilize as much tracking as possible. Then there are some portions that exhibit some extensive motion blur, such as the screen, left, wrist, and hand. And that will require some specific attention. But first, I want to talk about some customizations that I haven't gone over before. I'm going to zoom in here on the trees window by pressing the plus button. So I have my note up here in the trees window with my shot range and my to-do list. But I can change the background of my note if I want to. Just go to the options parameter here, make sure you select it on your note, go to options, and choose node color here, and I can just select a different color. And then I can show you how to edit the look and the feel of the trees window. So we can go to preferences, and we're in the user interface, and down here in the trees section. While I have curved lines connecting my nodes, I can switch them to straight and also change the color of them and the backdrop. So here I will select straight, and I can choose the connection color to be different. Click OK and apply. See how I like that. Then I can even change the background color. Right now it's a dark blue, but not black. And maybe I'll just make it a little bit lighter. Click OK and apply and see how I like that. And we'll go with that. Click OK. But before I do that, you can also see there's some other customizations here. You can change the default group color or the node color itself. That would change all the colors of your nodes. If we did that and chose perhaps a lighter color, click apply, and that's pretty bright. So maybe we'll just change that back to what the default was. And you can also change the input order, whether you want FG and BG to be left and right, or switch them up to be BG and FG. I'm going to leave mine at the default, which is FG, BG, and I keep my layout as vertical. Click OK, and now we can move forward.